Hi everyone, welcome to my channel. I'm Sadali, and today in this video I'll tell you how you can run Scrapy on your Google Colab. In this real quick video I'll tell you some basic steps, and first let me explain how you can create a Google Colab notebook. So to do that, you can simply type colab.google and press enter, and you will see something like this. Just click on new notebook, and it will create a new notebook for you. You will see similar window like this one. Okay, maybe the brighter one if you're working in a day, but all right, so let's try to install Scrapy first. But before that, make sure that if you look here, you'll see this connect button here. Just click on this to make sure that your instance is connected to the resources, RAM and disk. What basically happens is that Google allocate some resources whenever you create a new notebook. Alright. Okay, so it is let's sweat a little bit. Now, if you look here, it says RAM and disk. It means that I'm not using anything, so it is just straight green line here. So let me zoom in. Alright. Now if you look here, to install Scrapy, just type !pip3 install Scrapy. Okay, and click on this button. This should install Scrapy. Let me zoom out. All right, if you look here, it is installing all the Scrapy and its requirements. All right, so it is done. So let's try to create a simple spider and try to, run it here. Let's import Scrapy. Let's create a new cell, and now I already have Scrapy, but let's create a class here as my spider, and this class will inherit from scrapy.spider. Okay, now let's give it a name. Let's call it my spider as well. Allowed domain, let's ignore the allowed domain, just give it a start URLs equals to. Let's get a link to scrap. Okay, I'm going to use this link. Alright, so now we have our start URLs. Let's move on to creating a method. Alright, this is basically a built-in method which is parse. So let's create that and parse it. Parse the response as well. Now I'm not going to parse a lot of things. Let's just try to yield the links only, product links only. Okay, so let's create product links. So response.xpath, go back to the website and go to inspect. I'm going to get the link from this page, this point, which is alright, article clause. Right, so I've got the product links. Let's loop over them and yield them for link in product links. All right, yield link and link. Okay, let's run it. Okay, now it is loaded. Now let's create a new code and try to run this crawler right here. Now here I'm going to import something to run the spider here. So let's import that from scrapy.crawler. import. This is basically a process that's going to crawl the run this spider. Okay, let's create a process crawl spider crawler process. Okay, now here I'm going to pass the settings as a dictionary. Okay, settings equals to, now here I'm going to create a dictionary, which means that I'm going to pass some parameters. For example, if you want to add custom settings to this spider like you do in your scrapy project, you can pass all the settings here as a dictionary. Okay, right now I'm just going to go with fields, and fields name is supposed to be output, sorry, item.csv, let's call it item.csv. And here I'm going to pass one more thing, which is going to be the format. Alright, I think we are all good now. Sorry, I need to add one more dictionary here. Okay, fields needs to be a dictionary as well. And then we have another dictionary. Alright, so if you look here, we have created a process. Let's try to pass our class here. And remember that we have created this spider over here. So let's copy this spider and paste it here. Okay, now I'm going to process dot. Alright, now let's try to run this. Alright, so if you look here, we have got all the links here from start to end, and the scraper has completed successfully. But one problem is that you will not see any, you know, output file on your local computer, okay, because this computer is running on a remote Linux environment. So it will be, all the output files will be saved in that remote disk. So let me show you where are these saved. To see that, just type sign exclamation and ls and press enter, sorry, press click on this run button. Let me just remove this. And you will see this item.csv and sample data. This is basically item.csv is the file that we created. Let's try to open this with open item.csv as a readable file and save it as f. Let's try to print, sorry, f.read. Okay, so look here, we have got all the links from that page by crawling the website. So one of the reason, I mean, it is a good idea to use a notebook, this you know, environment for web scraping, because you don't want to occupy your computer for too long if you are running a scraper or anything. Because in some cases when you are building something else, let's say web development doing in within Python maybe, but what happens is that you are working on them and then you leave them, you know, you deploy them or something like that. But in case of Python web scraping, you have to monitor your scraper. It occupies a lot of you know, processing power of your computer and time. So it is a good idea. Maybe you can use this Colab efficiently and try to run your crawler instead of running them on your computer. You can run them on your you know, on this Colab as well. Okay, and you can also share this. If you want to discuss the same code with your colleagues or your friends, you can share that code with them as well. Okay, so I hope you I hope you like this video, and don't forget to thumbs up and subscribe to the channel as well. Have a good day.